Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, Nahmaduhu wa nasalli ala Rasulihil Kareem, amma ba'd. All praise to Allah and peace be upon Rasulullah and his family and companions. And all of us, Ibadallah, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu. Welcome back to Ramadan Sharing. The topic is Salat. We talked about the importance of prayer, the Ahamiya as-Salat. And we also talked about the five different stages of the prayers, according to Imam Ibn al-Qayyim. And this week, we are going to talk about the purpose of the prayer, the Maqasid of as-Salat. It is very important to understand why we are praying. By praying, what we are going to achieve. Without it, it's like just an act of worship, and without any understanding of why. So it will make us better if we know why we are praying. So when it comes to scholars, they have compiled many purposes of maqasid, purposes of prayer. So we are here compiled a few, around seven purposes that we are praying. Let us see one by one. The first one is actually Dhikrullah Azza wa Jal wa Taqarrubu Ilayhi, remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also the closeness, to getting close to Him, and also to revise the terms to Him. Because when we are praying, it's like we are revising the agreement with Him. It's like a one-on-one that we are actually talking to Him. That's what we are doing in the prayer. So according to the first one, if you look into the Quranic verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Wa aqimi salata li dhikri." So worship me and keep up the prayer so that you remember me. This is the surah. It is in the surah Taha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, "Wa aqimi salata li dhikri." When it comes to tafsir, one of the tafsir is by Ibn Ashur. He mentioned that the lam in li dhikri, the lam is actually, it is li ta'lil, is for the purpose, for the reason. It's actually, Allah says that you are praying because you have to remember me. So this is a kind of a road or the bridge to connect Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when we are praying. Also, when we are praying, it is actually not only that we are praying through our body, we are also praying through our heart. That's why it is the activity that made by the body at the same time by the sense, the mind, and also the heart. Not only that, it is also that we are doing it in mawaqit mutaqariba, meaning the very closed schedule. You can see starting from Fajr, Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, and Isha, then again it comes to Fajr. It's not like we are doing once a week or once a year. We are doing five times a day, which means that it's keep on refreshing in us that we have to do it for the Dhikrullah, the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second reason that we are praying is actually for Ta'zeemullahi Azza wa Jal, glorification, or you can call it magnification of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because when you are praying, you are actually doing the best form of magnification of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because inside the prayer, you have dua, you have a tilawa, recitation, you have the ruku', the act of ruku', the act of sujood, and then you also say Allahu Akbar takbir, you say subhanallah tasbih, you say alhamdulillah tahmeed. All this comes together and it makes your prayer better. That's why it's the best form of glorification of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number three, it is al-khulu, the submitting the will. Khulu wal-inqiyadu lillahi ta'ala is submitting your will to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because when you are taking wudu, and then you are standing and you are doing the ruku, and then you are doing the sujood, and then you are doing based on the raka'ah, it means that you are showing how slave you are. This is the act of slavery, right? So because we are the slave to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so this is what we call ubudiyah or ta'abudiyah. The fourth one, it's definitely it's for the tazkiyatu nafs, because purification of nafs is the most important part, that most important job that all the prophets were doing. Allah says in Quran, huwa alladhi ba'asa fil ummiyina rasulan minhum yathlu alayhim ayatihi wa yuzakkihim wa yuallimuhumul kitaba wal hikma wa in kanu min qablu lafi dhalalin mubin. He is the one who sent the messenger, who raised a messenger among the people who had no scripture to among the people who had no scripture. So he sent the messengers to them so that they can recite his revelations to them, and also to make them grow spiritually. This is what spiritually growing is, actually tazkiyatun nafs. And then we have number 5, an-nahi anil fahsha'i wal munkar. This is amazing Quranic verse. Allah says, "Inna salata tanha anil fahsha'i wal munkar." If you keep up the prayer will restrain outrageous and unacceptable behavior. Wala dhikrullahi akbar. Remembering God is greater, and Allah knows everything. So this is what, you know, when someone is actually doing this work of praying, he is actually, you know, going away, he is making himself away from all those unnecessary acts. The prayer, the act of prayer, it connects you to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As I told you, as we discussed earlier, it's a kind of, you know, you are actually glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are in a way that you are making yourself in a great connection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's like that connectivity will show you what kind of problems that you have, so that you can correct those. For example, people used to say your friend is your mirror. So when you see your mirror, you see how bad it is, and then you correct because you saw your problems. Similarly, when someone praying, it's like you see yourself when you are talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And definitely prayer is actually al-wa'idh an-nahi, which means that it's a very good for example, someone who give charama today is a very good man who actually gives khutbah, the one who gives bayan, who gives speech. So the prayer is the good speech for you. Number 6, the purpose of the prayer, number 6 is actually as-salatu ghadha'un lir-ruh. You know, this is the spiritual food. The prayer is the spiritual food. Like our body needs some food, we go around and we seek some sustenance, we make ourselves better. But this is the prayer. When someone pray, it is actually his mind and his soul is actually getting a kind of food which actually fulfilling the need, which is actually, we call it spiritual food. This is the reason why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say wasjud waqtarib. When you are doing sajda in a prayer, you are actually getting close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is a kind of, you know, food that our body need and our ruh need, because our body comes from the earth. So we use the earthy food to fulfill the need of the body, but our ruh is not from here. Allah says in Quran, وَنَفَخَ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he actually sent his ruh to us. He did that. So which means that it comes from him, it comes from the different world. So you need some different food for your ruh. إِنَّ أَقْرَبَ مَا يَكُونُ الْعَبْدُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ وَهُوَ سَاجِدٌ. This is what Prophet ﷺ said, a slave becomes nearest to his Rabb when he is in prostration, which is actually sujood. So increase supplication while prostrating. So fa aksir dua. That's why the best form of the dua is actually when you are doing the sajda and you are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because this is where you are connecting yourself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In fact, if you look into the Ibn al-Qayyim, he beautifully said, you know, the prayer is actually the comfort of your ayn, comfort of your eyes, qurratu uyun al-muhibbin wa ladhatu arwahul muwahhidin wa bustanul abidin. He says that it is a taste for those, you know, who says Allah is the one, who talks about the unity of Allah. Prayer is the only ladha, only taste, only recipe, only food. Also, this prayer is actually a garden for those who prayers. Those who perform prayers, this salah is the garden. So this is how he also brings an very good analogy, a very good example, metaphor. He says that, you know, if someone gives you a menu has full of colorful, you know, choices. It has everything, you know, starting from chicken, mutton, and you know, the seafood, also all sorts of juices, all sorts of vegetables, all sorts of, you know, so many things. He gives you 5 times a day, and every time he gives you a different menu. Would you like it? Definitely nobody say no to it. Everybody love it. Similarly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the opportunity to pray 5 times a day. It's like a 5 different menu in our plate. So we should be enjoying it like we enjoy our food. Okay, let's go to the last most important reason, the purpose that we are praying, which is actually as-salatu jala'u lil-humum wal-ahzan. Prayer is the remedy for the psychological disorder. This is something that, especially during the pandemic, we need to understand this, because many of us actually having problem, mental issues, because we are not able to go outside, we are not able to see our friends, the family is not actually united. So this is one of the thing. According to Ibn Ashur, he says that the prayer has a secret that only prayer can actually take away your problems, which is your mental problems. There is an event reported in some books. It's actually starting from Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu. When Abu Bakr wanted to pray, he asked someone to bring wudu, bring some water to take wudu, to take ablution. And then he said this, la'alli usalli fa'astarih, because I wanted to take wudu so that I can pray and I can relax. So when he said that I pray so that I can relax, then the people who surrounded by him, they will look at him, they think something different. Why? Usually people will say, okay, I will pray, after I finish praying I will go and relax. But Abu Bakr said, I will pray, and then because of the prayer, I relax. Then it was strange to others. Then Abu Bakr said, this is what I used to hear from Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He used to say, Qum ya Bilal, fa arihna bis salat. He said, go Bilal, give azan, and then let us go and pray so that you can bring the rest, the comfort through the prayers. فَأَرِحْنَا بِالشَّلَاتِ. So this is amazing. When Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam have any issues, you know, كَانَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ إِذَا حَزِبَهُ أَمْرٌ أَيْ نَزَلَ بِهِ شَلَّ. This is the prophetic hadith. Whenever Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was disturbed by a certain matter, anything that disturbs him, immediately he would resort to prayers. This is the only remedy for him. He goes to prayer. He pray. After finishing prayer, he relax. He feel comfortable. This is the reason why Ibn Rashid, he said in his book, فَالْعِبَادَاتُ هِيَ أَدَوِيَّةٌ لِأَمْرَاضِ الْقُلُوبِ. The salah is actually remedy for all kind of, you know, heart diseases, all kind of mental diseases, the inner diseases. This is the reason why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told this beautiful verse. This is the verse that I'm going to finish with this. This is the takeaway for today's session. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu ista'inu bishabri wa salah. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, seek help with steadfastness and prayers. So now, there is two elements that we are going to talk about it. You know, we talked about the purpose of the seven purposes that so far we compiled, the seven purposes of prayer. Now we are going to end with this Quranic verse, which is As-Sabr wa Salah. We want to know why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought these two things together. Ista'inu bis-sabri was-salati wa innaha lakabiratun illa 'alal khashi'in. So now, in order to understand why this shabr and salat are together, we need to go back one by one. We have several interpretations. So I'm going to start with apparent one, and then the second one, and the third one. The first one is, this is according to Mujahid, there is a scholar, Mufassirin. He says, as-shabr here, it refers to shiyam, which is actually fasting. So which means that, he says, this is the reason why Ramadan was mentioned as, was assumed as a shahru sabr, the month of sabr. Also, he quote from Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying that as-sawmu nisfu sabr, fasting is the half of the sabr. So this is the first interpretation, but apparent interpretation. If you look in this way, you will understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asking you to seek help with fasting and also prayer. But the second interpretation is better. The second interpretation, this is what Hazrat, this is what Khalifa Umar also said this, according to him. You know, the sabr is two types of sabr. As-sabr sabran. Sabrun indal musibati hasan wa ahsanu minhu as-sabr an maharimillah. You know, when there is a musibah, when there is a problem, issues comes to you, you become patient, it is a sabr. But the best sabr is when there is a prohibition, when there is a prohibition comes, you don't do that, you stop yourself. When there is a when there is something haram, you don't perform it, you keep yourself away from haram, it is also called sabr. Sabr is not something only when something bad happened to you, you become patient. Sabr also something when there is an opportunity, there is an opportunity for you to do haram, but you don't do, you stop yourself. It is also sabr. The third interpretation is also a very good interpretation. It comes, it says that, you know, sabr again is sabran. This is also two types of sabr. The one sabr is actually staying away from haram. The second sabr is the most important one. That is the maqsood. That is the purpose of sabr, which is you stay with good deeds. وَالصَّبْرُ عَلَىٰ فِعْلِ التَّاعَاتِ وَالْقُرْبَاتِ. Whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks you to do good things, whether it is a salat, whether it is a Shriyam, whether it's a zakat or hajj, or, you know, being kind or helping each other and following all the rules and regulations in Sharia, this is steadfast. Being firm and steadfast is actually sabr. So now Allah says, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu ista'inu bishabri, which means that you need to do the right thing all the time. Make sure that you do continuously. You don't stop. You don't stop. You do continuously. And then Allah says, As-Salat. Ista'inu bishabri was-salat. Was-salat is actually here the best form of the good thing to do. Good deeds to do. Good performance. So when you keep yourself, you know, make yourself continuously doing the good thing, and then ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you ask help. Allah will reveal the help to you. This is how Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was day and night was praying. You know, during the Laylatul Ahzab, that there was a holy war of Ahzab, the whole night he was praying. You know, even the Laylatul Badr, there was a Badr, the next day there is a Badr, before that there was a night, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was praying and praying until Subuh. Then the next day the battle of Badr was won by the Muslims. This is how you have to seek help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we don't have this attitude of asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to ask Him, but before that, we have to be steadfast. We have to do the right thing. Not once, not twice. We have to do it all the time. Then ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the help. The help will come to us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us steadfast. Make us do all the things, all the good deeds. Make us also to Him beloved, and also make our siyam and our zakat, everything accepted. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us in this blessed month of Ramadan. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.